Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss the elimination method, the procedure we are going to learn step by step. So this is a method to find the solution of a linear equation so in two variables, right? So we are going to solve that. So I have taken here two linear equation in two variables, x and y are the variables. So we are going to solve this. So first step is that you have to look first the equation, whether it is in the form of a standard form. If it is not there, you have to just simplify it, like taking LCM and all here. Here also you can take LCM. So I'll simplify first. So taking this equation, we are going to simplify. So LCM will be 6. Just multiplying this by 3, you will get 3x. Plus this by 2, you will get 4y. By 6, 6 is the LCM. Equal to what? Minus 1. Now you can shift to this side. 3x plus 4y. Is equal to minus 6, we can write. So we got it in the standard form, fine. So taking this one also, this equation, so we'll get how much? 3x minus y by 3 is equal to what? 9. This will be 3 only, right? So 3x, we are just taking the LCM, this will be 1, so multiplying with 3, so 3x minus y by 3 is equal to 3. Now what happens, you have to shift to that side, so you will get 3x minus y is equal to 9, fine. So this is the equation, first equation we can say, this is the second equation. Now using these two equations, you have to do the elimination method and find out the value of x and y. So what we can do is that in the elimination method, the name says that you have to eliminate some terms. That means, so we are going to write, suppose 3x plus 4y equal to minus 6 is the first equation. Second equation is equal to 9, right? Now, keep the constants on the RHS, fine? Other terms on the LHS. Now, what you have to do? You have to eliminate. See the terms. See, you can see here, 3x and 3x are same, right? They are same. Now, you can do one thing. You can subtract. Subtract means you can change the sign and subtraction you can give. So when you give the subtraction sign, this will get cancelled because 3x minus 3x will be 0, right? So you have to eliminate one term. That will be, you can eliminate either x term or y term, you can eliminate. If the terms are not same, you have to make it as same. That means you have to make this term as, suppose we can say, see, suppose the equation was 3x plus 4. First equation, I will take it as same. Second equation, suppose it was this thing, fine? Suppose 3 is not there. So you can observe here, this in this two equation, nothing is common. Fine, nothing is same, right? No terms are same. So what you have to do, you have to multiply with such a term that you will get the same term. Suppose we are going to eliminate x term. So you have to multiply the whole equation by 3. So when you multiply with the whole equation by 3, you will, this equation will form it as 3x minus 3y equal to 27. Fine. Now these terms are same, right? The x terms coefficient becomes same. So then you can apply elimination method. So you have to make one or the other term as the same. Same terms you have to make, like terms. Now we got the like terms. That means these two terms are same. Then you can do what? You can just subtract. So what we are going to do is that this is the first equation. This is the second equation. Fine. Now what we are going to do, we are going to do subtract 1 minus 2 minus second equation minus first equation we are going to do. Now when we subtract this thing, we will get it as how much? This becomes 0 because 3x minus 3x is 0. Now this is minus y. Minus y, and you are going to subtract 2 minus 1. So minus y, this becomes minus 4y. So this becomes minus 4y, right? And equal to, what is there? This is 9, this is minus 6, so this becomes 9. This goes that side, so plus 13 it becomes, fine. This will become minus 5y equal to 30. So y will be how much? Oh, this will be 15, right? Yeah, 15. Because 9 plus 6 is how much? 15. Oh, yeah. So this will become 15. Now you just have to bring it on to the next side. So this becomes what, minus this thing. So this get cancelled, 3 is a, so minus 3. So y value we got it as what, minus 3. Now what about the x value? X value you can do just to substitute this y value in any of this equation. Fine. In any of this equation you can substitute. So while when you substitute, we'll say, suppose we'll take this equation, will take, fine, 3x plus 4y equal to minus 6. You have to substitute y value here. So this becomes 3x plus 4 into minus 3 equal to minus 6. Fine, you got this much. Now what you have to do, then you have to shift all terms to the right side. So this becomes minus 6, minus 12 goes that side, so plus 12, fine. So 3x becomes how much, 6, x becomes how much, x becomes 6 by 3 is nothing but 2. So x value also we got. So x value got, and y value is nothing but minus 3 we also got. So this is the procedure of elimination method. So in elimination method you have to remember one thing, is that suppose two equations are given, you just simplify it to bring to this form, fine. And after that you have to shift constant terms to the RHS, keep constant terms on the RHS, then you have to eliminate a term, that means which are same terms you can eliminate, so that you will get it in the form of, you can get the value of y. Either you eliminate the value of x, eliminate the terms of x, or you can eliminate the terms of y. If you eliminate the terms of x, you will get y value. If you eliminate the terms of y, you will get x value. Here we have eliminated which term, x term, so we got the value of y, fine. Then just to substitute the y value in any of this equation. This equation you can substitute, you can get the value of x also. So this is a procedure you have to follow to do elimination method.